Every American hockey player, at some point in their lives, has the same dream, to play for a state championship. Five long years have passed since St. Mary's won its 2017 Division I state championship. Each passing season serves only to fortify the resolve of each of these men to reclaim what was once theirs.
Coming into this game, that's the underdog with four losses on the year. All right, they feel disrespected. I want you guys. You guys have to be up to the challenge. You can't take a step back. You guys have been playing great. Gotta keep it going.
Practices leading up to the first of what the Spartans hope will be five playoff games are noticeably more intense than previous sessions. Expectations from the coaching staff are simple. You've had 22 games to get everything right. Now it's time to prove it.
Oh, what a beat! How we doing?
Tempo up. We're really good out there right now.
We had some pretty rough practices this year. I knew going to playoff, we couldn't have any rough practices. We needed to work hard and just be good. Because we knew every team we were going to play in playoffs was going to be good.
No clue. Just I'm gonna tell you right now. Wait till you see what happens.
Him and Bullsy are scheming. Nothing will happen.
Oh my god. Me and Bullsy are scheming a lot, and you'll see what happens.
And I welcome adversity, buddy.
Thank you. today was a real good practice.
All right, boy. Let's go, boys. Come out flying every day from here on out. Every day could be our last day if you think about it from here on out,
boys. Should be fun.
Give me a ride, though.
No, come out flying, boys. All right, Spartans on three. 1, 2, 3. Spartans.
The Spartans are ranked 15th in the Division 1 power rankings and will be taking on number 18 ranked Chelmsford High School, a team playing its first season in Division 1, yet has already cemented its status as a force to be reckoned with.
We're home bowling, Brent. Nobody's beating us here. Nobody's beating us here.
It's a lot about the preparation the night before those games. You know it's going to be a dogfight. You know everyone's going to come out firing. Playoff hockey is nothing better than it. Like, literally a regular season game is nothing compared to a playoff hockey game.
That was the first ever playoff game that St. Mary's have ever played at Connery, and I think any team has ever played at Connery.
I think we were all just really nervous as a team, and I talked to Coach Anno, and although I was a veteran in his eyes, that was my first ever time starting in the state tournament, so that was new for me as well, even though being one of the sort of leaders on the team. So that was, even for me, it was nerve-wracking. You don't know what to expect. They were a good team. Watched film on them. They had a couple good power forwards. They had a decent goalie. And then I think leading up to it, we were all just kind of not knowing what to expect out of them.
Thank you, John. 10-7 and 5. 10-7 and 5.
10-7 and 5. Yeah.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Just start. All right, listen up. So you've played 22 games. You've become a family. We've been through some ups and some downs, a lot of mistakes, and a lot of mistakes that have turned into good for us because we've corrected those mistakes. This is an opportunity for all of us to put everything we've learned the entire season on the ice to show. So we need a room full of focused guys that are going to go out there and know that the game of hockey is played in three zones. The most important zone is the defensive zone. We need good defensive coverage. We know that. These games are very, very close. So we want to make sure we pay attention to detail in our own zone, using our sticks, taking lanes away, stopping and starting, not looping. Then we're going to obviously do the 1-2-2 in the neutral zone. 1-2-2 in the neutral zone, pretty easy, right? And then in the offensive zone, the first two lines, let's go with the 1-1-1-2, okay? To start. And three, aggressive 1-2-2. Okay, DB aware who's out there. There is one line that they have, and we're gonna probably try to match it. We have last change. One line of theirs does most of their scoring. So if we're looking for a quick shift, or if three gets caught out there against one, we might say change quickly. Not it, you know what I mean? We want to put our one against their one, or maybe two, whatever it is. But we want to make sure we're matching. Other than that, you've won the opportunity to host in your barn for the first time, and it will mean nothing unless you take pride in the fact that this is your house. And this is where you want people to come and be afraid to play. And that's where it starts today. We go out there and we own the house that we've been playing in for the last 3 months solid. But again, just think about the things. One-on-one battles, face-offs, all the things, not a f***ing shift off. Because that one shift off or that one misplay could be the difference of going home or going on. Think about it. That's what makes it fun. It's exciting to be a part of this. Can't wait for this game. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. Let's go, boys.
Hurry up and bring it up. Bring it in tight. As a family. Hey, boys, this is the game we've been waiting for since the first game of the season. Now let's just come out here and work. Go.
So all you gotta do is come out here and work your ass off, boys. That's what we gotta do. We gotta take care of business. This is our rights. We own it, all right? Let's go. Everyone knows what to do. Do your job.
Every workout, every ounce of sweat and energy you've put into this, it comes down to right here. Right. Whoever wants it more is gonna compete with this.
All of go. Let's fucking go. Bring it up.
Go. Go. Hey, boys, remember, no goalie, a lot of shots, all right? 07.
Come on, rip on. We're not going home. Let it go. 5, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Let's go. Go, boys.
Go, dude.
One more lap.
Boys. Coming out of a locker room for the first playoff game, one can't help but think of the effort it took just to get here, the sacrifices made, the bumps, bruises, cuts, and sweat given to have even a minute chance of competing for glory. When the stakes are at their highest, the lights are at their brightest.
We knew it was going to be packed. There was a lot of people there that night. It was loud.
We had a great week of practice leading into the Chelmsford game. We were all clicking in practice, so we were pretty confident going into it.
I've never seen this many people at Quandary. I didn't know this many people could get in. They really have a jam at home. 28 seconds in. 28 seconds in. Shot. Being grand, he grabs it, tries to tie it up. It's loose. He finally grabs it.
Oh, you got to play. Oh, I remember.
Shoot it.
Jack?
Yep.
Jack's tired, definitely.
Coventry, I have Coviello on the penalty kill. Piagrande got a pad on the shot. It popped up in the air, and Chelmsford banged it home. That's a tough goal to give up with 34 seconds left.
The first period wasn't necessarily a bad period for me at all. I was gotten unlucky. I had a bad turnover in the corner that led to a pass out front back door, and then they tapped one in the first minute. And so everyone's nerves were especially high, and then we were all kind of like, oh, shit, we need to get this together.
Yeah, all right, we put ourselves in a hole. Big deal. All right, we battled back
with
two
get the
goals.
Out of
plenty of hockey left. No time for panic, not time to get down on your line mates and stay positive, and we fight back. That's what we do.
So we talk about it. It's a marathon. And most of the stats that we took in the first period are very even, other than the score sheet from the goals. Other than that, even. And we've had a couple that we could have put in. So we just need to, a couple of odd man rushes into the zone. We did zone entry and created nothing. We got to start hitting the tape of the other, your other line mates, giving opportunities. We're throwing some away because we're not accurate with passes and so forth. So that, they like to go D to D a lot. That's why we're going 1-1-1-2. That second guy's got to be aware, reading. The first guy's got to pressure that D so he doesn't have time and space. Make that deep pump it to his partner. The second guy should be releasing, seeing it happening. Third guy's high, reacting either way. That forecheck will work. But unfortunately, we're not getting the first guy in there quick enough. The second guy isn't really reading good enough. So we got to do a little better job. And again, face-offs, they had a couple of opportunities in our zone, guys, off face-offs, getting shots on our goaltender. So that starts with the three forwards not doing your job in our zone. So what you have to do is understand we're taking one period at a time, one shift at a time. So we're not panicking. We're not rookies that think, oh, shit, run and gun, let's just, no. We're in the f***ing beginning of the second period. Plenty of time. We're going to chip away at it. Start getting better. We had a big layoff, okay? Now it's time to second and third period kick it in to the St. Mary's hockey. We made some mistakes. But it wasn't awful. We're better than that period, though. So that's what we need to be this period.
I was pretty pissed off. I was shocked, to be honest. It was the first time ever Connery has hosted a playoff state hockey game. So, like, if we lost that game at our home barn in front of the whole city of Lynn, we would have felt like we were the worst hockey team in the state, even though we had a pretty good record going into that.
I went in there, and when everyone got in, I shut the door, and I just said, well, what the f*** are we doing?
I people were probably getting a little bit nervous because they're like, damn, we might lose this game. But, you know, Toto can even back me up. Sometimes after, like, periods where we're down, I'm just like, we're fine, boys. Even Cam knows. Like, we were playing Pope Francis and we were down, wow. and we beat him. And I was like, we're going to be fine. We're gonna come back. We got this game, you know.
Just remind everyone we're still in a game, you know. If we panic now and freak out now, it's basically over. So especially having such a young team, just try to remind the guys all to stay calm. And we had Chris Price, who's one of the assistant coaches. He'd been there not too long ago, used to play, and he was a good guy to have there just to let us know, like, we have to score anyway to win. Just stay calm and play till the end, and that's the only way we have a chance to come back.
I remember Mike Reddy coming in. This is all I remember, to be honest. My favorite part. Mike Reddy coming in and him firing us up and saying, like, play Spartan hockey. Like, I remember him saying that, like, just play Spartan hockey. And, like, we all knew, who he is, like, who his son is. And we all knew, like, what we really needed to do that game.
At one point in the second period, the Spartans had multiple defensemen in the box at the same time, on, let's just say, some questionable calls. With the remaining D forced to play extra minutes to compensate, someone has to come in cold off the bench.
Definitely felt good knowing that the coaches trust me enough to throw me out there as a young kid on the team. It was definitely nerve-wracking for me, especially knowing because I wasn't out there that much throughout the whole season. It's also good that, you know, they just threw me out there and it was a very crucial point in the game. And I knew I had to work my tail off to, you know, kill off that penalty.
Necessity has forced younger players to take on more and more ice time and responsibility as the season has progressed. Players like Ben Fry.
It felt really good to be able to start making a real impact on the team and to be able to help them win games. Getting there, I just had to keep my head up and work hard, even if I hadn't been playing the beginning of the season.
Discipline, in the morning, getting up and stretching before our game.
Yeah. I had Surrett tell me that if they don't score again, we have a chance of winning this game, so that's what I plan on doing.
The penalty provides the first big break St. Mary's has gotten all night. To this point, Chelmsford goalie Mark Beerworth has been playing spectacularly.
Seconds of counting in the period. 25 seconds left on the man advantage. St. Mary's would like to do what Chelsea did, score a late goal.
So O'Hare had an open shot, that's all it was, and then shot it low because he's a good hard slap shot, and I just found the puck on my stick and it went in.
You're being Spartan High hockey players.
Boys, before we got six penalties, we had them that whole period. This team's not as good as us even strength. We gotta stay out of the box. We're due for a couple of power plays now.
So, it's really, hockey is all about whoever shows up. You can prepare all you want, and you just have to have that mindset that I'm gonna work the hardest and I'm gonna win this game.
The third period of any hockey game, regardless of the score, always feels like a never-ending ordeal. Time is winding down on the St. Mary's season, second by second.
You know, we're gonna run out of time. That's what I was really thinking in my head. And I got to the third period, and we had less than 5 minutes left. And then it was kind of just like an oh shit moment in my head. I'm like, this isn't like, I was thinking like, what if we don't pull this off? What if like, I'm not ready to be done with my season yet.
There is, however, a marked improvement in the Spartans' play ever since McGonagall's second period goal. The ice has been firmly tilted in favor of the Spartans for the past period and a half. With 2 minutes remaining, St. Mary's takes its timeout down 2-1, for which the coaches have the perfect play.
I remember Coach Smitty and Coach Surratt drew up a play for the faceoff.
So that play, it's called Toronto. We used to run that in practice. Before practice, we'd hop out there 20 to 30 minutes early with Coach Surratt, and he would run us through Toronto. And so basically,
normally we set up on the side, the other side, the left side, so I could get the one-timer option, and that was the main play. So we had to set up, we had to completely change that because we worked on my side more than the other side because we figured that's the side we would be on for whatever reason. But
Cheener would either like win a face-off back to me at the point, and I'd go down the wall.
And we had been working on this every practice, so just goes to show, you work on it, perfect it.
The main play is to either pass it to Bulsey or Domeniconi cutting back door. But on that play against Chelmsford, I remember it was one of my feet, and I brought it down to the corner. And thank God for number 17, my other captain, because I threw it in front trying to get it to Bulsey back door, and all I remember is Shamer stopping it right there dead in its tracks and passing it to Bulsey, and Bulsey tapping it in for like the easiest goal of our season.
They dropped the puck and run away in the final 2:06. They knock it home! St. Mary scores! I think it was Bott. It wasn't, it was Bullock.
Overtime has not been St. Mary's best friend this season. They hold an 0-1-5 regular season record in games that went to either overtime or a shootout, so history isn't exactly on their side.
I came in thinking regular game, safe plays, making passes, good shots, like no extra rushing the puck because gotta play safe.
To be honest, everyone wants to be the hero. Everyone's gonna come in, everyone's gonna shoot. Everyone's gonna crash the net, everyone's gonna go for that goal because you wanna be that guy that scores overtime goal. And that's pretty much why everyone stepped their foot on the gas in the other zone.
Take it,
thank you.
Yeah, it really stinks when you hit a crossbar a couple times in overtime, but we knew the whole entire second half of the third, along with OT, we were the better team. We really controlled the play for the last second half of the game, so we just knew if we kept chipping away, it was going to go in at some point.
I'm not even going to narrate this. No special effects. Just roll the clip.
I took it wide. He came from the corner. He tried to get it across, and it kicked out right to the slot. I just came across and put it in top left. I've never been on the ice like that with my dad, so especially at that moment, it was pretty cool. He gave me a hug and told me how happy he was for me, so it really meant a lot. Like, all these things that we've been through, like having these seasons and doing all this stuff for hockey, it was really great to have that moment.
You should have seen Bozy at lunch.
I don't know where it's from, but this is the best chicken bar I've ever had.
Where's it from?
If the boys thought Chelmsford was a challenge, life wasn't about to get any easier, as they will now take on number 2 ranked Xaverian Hawks.
We were pretty confident. I think the Chelmsford game, all the nerves were kind of gone after that. We played in a home game, wicked packed rink, so there was really no need to be nervous against Xaverian. We were the underdog. We had nothing to lose, but we definitely thought we could win. We were still confident from the Chelmsford game.
Don't piss in the wind, don't tug on Superman's cape, and never stab your brothers in the back.
Let's go.
I remember that. Let's go!
Let's go. Wow. All right, boys, we have to come out flying on this team. We got to surprise them. That's what I wanted to say the most. This team thinks it's going to be easy. You know that. They were laughing at us when we walk in, bro, because we look tiny. Like, come on, let's come out, bro. Let's come out and win a game in the first period for once. For Coach Lee, too. We're doing this for Coach Lee today. We got to work today, and we got to want this. For every Lee, for every Ready, for everyone that's ever played for St. Mary's,
hockey. Like, we got to do this today.
What's
like,
better than being the underdog, boys? Bro, literally.
This is like, we have no pressure on us. All the pressure is on them. Like, let's go out there, play our game, and we got this, boys. Like, you just got to work. You just got to want it in your brain. We'll get it. Let's go. I'm not going out today. I don't know about you, boys. Let's go. Spartans on three. One, two, three.
Spartans!
All right, let's get in there. I see you holding out my chains, I'm
Alright, watch you guys say hello.
You're like lacrosse, captains! Down the shoes.
Alright, Mark, why don't you start us off here, buddy?
I gotta tell you guys, just play hockey. Right? We'll call the first, like we'll call the third. You know, violent stuff, change possession, scoring ops. You know what to expect. Just play hard, be smart, have fun. Right?
Yeah, so I mean, at this time of year, guys, just pass the word, stay off the goaltender, right? And then when the whistle blows, get ready for the faceoff, you know? No monkey business. Do you guys have any questions for us at all? Matt, do you want to add anything?
You know, during the face-offs, I want to see some space in between the wings on each side. Nobody coming in behind me too close. So,
focus, sir.
Proper face-off.
Coach, good luck. Have fun, guys.
Thanks, guys.
What side are we on?
Over here. Just gonna pass it. Hang up on the glass, all right? You guys already do the pucks that I'm going to
do? No, not yet.
I'm doing that, all right?
Challenge. You are now recognized amongst the state as top 16. Sweet 16 is the basketball. That's an honor. But you know what? We know we can move forward and be better than Sweet 16. But to do that, you have to play one of the very best teams in the state. It's a team that we right now are thinking that they're in our way to the place that we want to go. So we need to get inside our inner selves, every single guy, because it's going to take every single guy in this room to contribute. And you need to bring your best today as an individual and as a team player. You have to win the one-on-one battles. You have to make it actually personal during this game. Every battle is personal. It's you against your opponent. We need structure. That's when we're our best, structure. And you remember the other night when we were killing off two men down, the structure, the things that we did, and then to come back and to score at the end of two men down for quite a, that is your character. That's the character of this team. So you need to understand that there's nothing that we can't do as a unit, as a family, as a group. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let's go!
Yeah.
think just their experience and their speed kind of got to us. They had 15 plus seniors. They got some skilled kids on that team, and they were able to put it to us in the offensive zone. And they kind of got to us, and then our team was young. We never really faced a team of that caliber before.
In a trend carrying over from round one, officiating is not exactly on its game tonight, levying a series of, let's say, questionable calls against the Spartans, leaving key players in the box for extended periods of time, which X is all too happy to capitalize on. A 3-0 deficit in a round 2 playoff game may seem insurmountable, but you gotta remember this. In hockey, the fight is never truly over till you hear the final buzzer.
We took the second. Let's take the third and take the game.
Hey, come on, boys!
Fellas, you outshot him. I'll beat him in face-offs. You beat him all over the ice.
X was able to maintain offensive zone possession for the better part of the first 3 to 4 minutes of the third period, culminating in their fourth tally of the game.
Thank you.
To say, I will say that I am so proud of this team. This team is special. The first thing that coach said to me is I would never want to play this team next year, because he knows he had a full team of seniors, and we've got a lot of young guys with some quality seniors, obviously. But it was an effort. We made a couple of mistakes. That team had a lot of talent. That team is very capable of winning the entire, state tournament. And you battled them to the end. And you battled. And let me tell you, what a f***ing great year you gave all of us as coaches and yourselves as players. We saw so much improvement from day one till today. And I love this locker room. I love the guys in it. I love the seniors that have given everything they've had and will be sorely missed. And that is what we deal with every year. Unless you win your last game, it kind of sucks. But you know what? We f***ing achieved so much this year, and there is not a guy in here that should hang their head and just be proud of what you've accomplished this year. And like I said, I've done this so many years, and there are some years that at the end I can't wait for it to be over. This is one of those years I wish it just could keep going and going and going, because it starts in the locker room, and you got a great locker room. Thank you, guys. Thanks for everything you gave.
I miss you. You're
smiling, all right? You're a great man. Come on, Captain.
No.
Unbelievable job. Be proud. All seems to work.
Losing, you never like losing. And I mean, especially when you got a family, like, you never want to leave your brothers. And I mean, I'll never forget the memories we made this year. And I just love my boys a lot.
It's a terrible feeling, but 31 out of the 32 teams that play got to feel it. So it just goes to show how much you got to work in order to be that one team that is able to hold the trophy at the end of the year. And it's never easy to say goodbye to your teammates, regardless if they're leaving or coming back. Like, I had to say goodbye to a couple of seniors, like Jake and Seamus. They're my best friends. Like, I came really close with them. Me and Seamus came up on this team together from Gold Lines with Kyle, and it was very tough to just have to realize that you got to say goodbye to your boys. You're not going to be able to play hockey with them.
Yeah, it's one of the worst feelings ever, really. It's hard to describe. Not even so much the hockey, just being around the boys, the locker room, everything that's involved with high school hockey, just showing up every day with your friends and getting to like hang out, play hockey. It's just a terrible feeling that it's all gone.
I guarantee if you've played high school hockey or any club team, it's gonna happen. You're always like gonna lose at some point. But I was sad that game. I love the team this year, so I'm gonna miss it.
Hockey players are indeed a special breed of athlete. Coming out of my cage and I've been doing just fine. Gotta be down because the bond between this band of brothers is unbreakable. Prodigy talents alongside distinctive leaders, fearless combatants amongst relentless competitors. And my stomach is sick, and it's all in my head, but she's touching his chest now. He takes off her dress now, let me go. In order to be the very best, one must not simply be talented, but resilient. A trait which will forever tell the tale of this season's St. Mary's High School men's hockey team. For the game they love demands it. Jealousy, tiny saints into the scene, swimming through sick lullabies, choking on your alibis. But it's just the price I pay. Destiny is calling me. Open up my eager eyes, 'cause I missed the bright side. I took a lot of grief throughout the season for choosing these boys for this series' inaugural season. And looking back, nah, I wouldn't trade a second of it for anyone else.